Oh boy. What's up, good people? Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to say thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Jobu Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. Man, I am so happy to be back home. You know, I love working on the Red Brick House, but I love being here too. And it's amazing. The helicopters have finally fallen off the tree in the front. They finally stopped and got a few remnants here and there. Here's one of them. Hate these damn things. Okay? Every year. But the flowers are growing like crazy. My daughter's watering them while we're not here. They've really grown like crazy. And it just feels good to be sitting here at the fire pit. Hopefully, we'll be getting the red brick house done soon. And I'll be maybe building a fire pit there. So that way, when I am down there working and stuff, because brother got to eat. So you got to do put in the work to get the work done and stuff. But maybe I'll put in a fire pit there so that way I can do the same thing there. I got to check on the fishies and make sure they're okay and give them something to eat as well. So tonight I was talking about the Eagles. The Eagles are now the darlings of the NFL. Everybody thinks that they're the juggernaut to worry about, that they're the bomb diggity, that they went to the Super Bowl this past year, that they're automatically going to have a season like they had last year. And you can't, I mean, I don't like the Eagles, okay? But you have to respect what they've done. I know it sucks when you say Eagles and respect in the same sentence. I hate to do it. But man, they are feeling themselves, literally, as well as their fans. It's almost getting to be comical. So here it is, DeAndre Swift throws major shade at the Dallas Cowboys. This mother humper just got back to Philadelphia. So, after being traded back from the Lions, where he really couldn't stay healthy, okay? From the Lions. He goes back to Philadelphia, he gets the number zero, okay? Saved by zero, I guess. And, you know, everybody's all excited about DeAndre Swift. He's back. Yeah, okay, DeAndre Swift. Ooh, Howie Vision. Philly 500 just popped a video out apologizing to Howie Roseman, you know, because he said, best draft, you know, has been drafting crazy for the last 3 years. Howie Roseman. They love him. But, you know, things can turn real quick with Eagle fans. So DeAndre Swift was asked, DeAndre, why are you getting the number zero? His response was, because that's the number of NFC championships that the Dallas Cowboys have been to in my lifetime. Yo, bro. Bro, come here for a second. I understand that. Cowboys haven't been to the NFC Championship. I get that, right? I understand that, you know? It's cool. But, bro, you do know the last time the Detroit Lions, the team you just left, was even in the playoffs, the Cowboys beat them. Now, I don't know. You know, I can understand if you have been on the Eagles and things and losing to Dak Prescott, that maybe you would throw shade at them. But coming from an organization that has pretty much sucked throughout the majority of its existence in the Super Bowl era, I know they did go to that one NFC Championship game. They did have Barry Sanders and stuff. The fact that that team actually had a coach that took them to the playoffs 2 or 4 years and decided, nah, that's not good enough for us Lions, and got rid of him, that maybe you ought to just be happy that you escaped from Detroit. Here's an interesting thing. Now, I ain't been to Detroit it's probably been about 7 years or so since United Way stopped doing the halftime show. But I used to go to Detroit every Thanksgiving. Every Thanksgiving, you know. Me and the wife would be there, the halftime show. People in Detroit were like family. But you know what? I remember the first year that I went to Detroit. Because whenever I would go to a new city, I would always say, what is the one thing you must do in your city? You know, what is the one thing that if you could only do one thing that you can't leave that city without doing? You know, some people would say Philadelphia, see the Liberty Bell, go to Pat and Geno's, you know, something like that. You know, go to New York City, go to Times Square, you know, or go on top of the Empire State Building, you know, something like that. Bro, in Detroit, I asked a cab driver, because the cab driver, he drives all over Detroit. I said, hey, man, I'm only in Detroit for a few days. What's the one thing I got to do in Detroit before I leave? He said, bro, get out alive. What? I said, no, I mean, is it like the Motown Museum or, you know, is it a certain place? I know there's a hot dog place. He said, bro, get out alive. And he was dead serious. So there's that. Here's the thing that's so comical to me. I agree, the Eagles are a very good team. I'm not going to lie to you and say they're ass. I can at least recognize talent in what they did. Eagles, I'm not trying to throw shade at you, but you, let's be clear here. You had the second place schedule that you had some patsies on there. You can't look at when you play the Colts with Jeff Saturday as the head coach, that was a juggernaut team. And you barely beat them. In all rights, you should have lost to them. You can't look at the Chicago Bears, who you got lucky, where Jalen Hurts looked like ass, throwing two interceptions. You got lucky with the Jalen Hurts run up the middle to save the game. You can't look at some of those teams you face that had ass for quarterbacks and say, we played a tough schedule. To your credit, you took care of business against the teams you had to play. But if you think that it's all going to go that way, you're crazy. You guys did good with injuries. You didn't face adversity. Jalen Hurts, the book really wasn't out on him. Bro, every defensive coordinator staff has been studying the hell out of what you did last year and saying, we're not going to let Jalen Hurts run like he did last year. We're going to keep his ass in the pocket. We're going to slow him down. I dare say that the Dallas Cowboys draft was about making sure that Jalen Hurts, as well as other running quarterbacks, don't hurt him. I'm going to say that this draft was about fixing the big problem that they've had against the San Francisco 49ers. And that is stopping the run. Something the Eagles game is predicated on. That's why we get a Mozzie Smith, a big man in the middle. That's why we bring back Hankins. That's why we hold on to Quentin Bohannon. We got big guys to stuff the pocket, to clog up the middle. If you don't think that teams aren't going to look at you the way they look at the Cowboys and say, we can make our season by beating those guys. You got a target on your back. And the last thing you really want to do is start in the offseason with bulletin board material. DeAndre Swift, really? You just got right back there. And you're already talking smack about the Cowboys? Come on, man. Nah. Not today. I can't believe you guys, man. But hey, what do we expect from Eagle fans? They got no couth. Whew. Oh, man. It feels so nice. It's a little chilly out here, but you know that spring is about to turn into summer in a few more weeks. Well, several more weeks. And you know that we are, let's see, it's May.
May 5th, June,
July. 2.5 months away from training camp. It's not far away. In fact, it might be time to go ahead and start the clock over. I think we've had enough of the off season that we can start counting down to the season. I am excited and I am ready. And I've got to, I've been neglecting my outdoor studio here. And I have some ideas for some new stuff inside the main studio that I want to implement in here that I think will be really, really good. Good experience wise for you, the viewer. I want to add some few new bells and whistles and really spend some time being able to do some really cool stuff. So I'm going to go to bed tonight, get me a good night's sleep, and I'm going to start putting in the work on getting everything else together back here again. I go 1,000 miles an hour. And people always tell me to slow down, especially my wife, because she's like, I don't want to see you in an early grave. She's like, I need you. But there's so many things that I want to do and want to accomplish, and it's just not enough hours in the day to get it done. That the only way I can get anywhere close to it is by going 1,000 miles an hour. But I am so blessed. I stay busy, I wear myself out, but I wouldn't want my life any different. And I certainly wouldn't want it without you guys. I appreciate all of you guys, even you Eagle fans. And that makes me want to put in the extra work for you guys. Remember to tell the people you love them, because you might not get the chance again. And I love you guys. And God willing, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace.